Welcome back, everyone, to the MLG Pro League, where we are seeing Alliance go up against mY Insanity. Now, mY Insanity took Game 1 pretty convincingly with their tiny wisp, but there'll be none of that this game. Joining me will be Ar1se. How are you doing, man?
Привет. Yeah, I'm excited for this game.
Хорош.
Хорошо.
Let's see what's going on here, man.
I don't know. I love that language.
It's so... There. It's not subtle or anything. It's just like, these are the words. These are what they mean. There's no sort of playing around. But we see Troll Warlord straight up for Alliance. Now, they tried to bait this out because they banned out the Axe and then they saw the Wisp ban and they knew they had first pick. So, mY Insanity had like a choice between Jug or Troll to ban out. So, Alliance knew they were getting one of those heroes. They get the Troll in the end.
We have a different drafter. This time it's Pycat drafting. And... he insta-picked the Troll Warlord, by the way. When they banned the Jugger, he didn't think at all about the if I want to pick it or not. I think he had his
cursor
mouse
selected on it.
Prep on it, yeah, and he just clicked it instantly. I think this was the fastest pick I've ever seen in a Dota draft. So yeah, we see SF Venge, SF on Radiant. It's really, really strong. It's stronger than on Dire because of the camps. They're so much closer.
You've got the medium camp that you can just run to in between waves.
Yeah, you run
the large
there, you stack it. Yeah, Venge can stack
the large camp.
Whoever. You kill them so fast with Brazes. When you feel the enemy supports are missing, when you feel the mid lane is in danger for you, you can just go there, chill, farm the camps. And it's the Yule thingy. I think Yule Scepter, it's really, really strong on this hero. But Alliance, I like the Shaker pick against SF because until he gets BKB, if Shaker just sits behind... SF goes Yule someone, he tries to ulti him, but the Shaker with the Fissure can interrupt it. So, until he gets a BKB, Shaker should be able to prevent these things happening.
Also a pretty good hero up against roaming supports like Vengeance Scarth, who want to move from lane to lane and make things happen.
Yeah, also that. Definitely.
Earthshaker can, you know, sit behind the Troll Warlord for a bit, maybe.
Oh, I think this is a pick that... This Droll Ranger, I think Alliance knew... Guessing mY Insanity wanted to pick it, and I think they wanted to pick it with... They have three range heroes with VS and SF, and I saw them doing this, I think, a few days ago in an official. They went for SF draw and Queen of Pain offlane.
How?
So, yeah, looks like they wanted this Droll Ranger pick, but Alliance... sort of ban it by picking it, you know.
And look at how slowly mY Insanity are acting here. I think you're dead on because they're thinking really hard about their fourth pick. Like, oh, what do we do now?
Yeah, they're... I think they didn't expect Alliance to pick Droll, so they're thinking now what to get because I'm pretty sure they wanted a Droll Ranger, so it's our Earth Ember Spirit. Right?
So is that going to be roll one safe lane Ember Spirit then? Radiant
team. Because I think it's a safe lane Ember. You don't want to put Ember Spirit versus Troll Warlord mid.
Very true.
So SF can have a nice time against Troll Warlord. In the early stages, it's quite rough, but after you get level 3, you can just come back and farm. Like I said, you farm the median camps, and we see a Visage. So it's a Droll Visage lineup. And Troll Warlord benefits from the aura when he's on range form.
Yeah, but that was so easy for Alliance. Like, the Drow, fair enough, might have been a block pick, but the fact they got it in their third pick, and then fourth, they could take up Visage straight away, and, you know, you can't get banned out. It just sort of clicked for Alliance there.
Yeah, but I gotta say though, Ember is a really good hero against Droll Ranger. These heroes, Ember is a hero when you can just be in your face and they have a Scarlet Mage, Ember plus Kai, a lot of amount of burst towards the Droll Ranger. She can just die insta to Mystic Flare or Searing Chains from Ember into Mystic Flare.
Yeah, they're very good at closing distance. Concussive Shot to slow someone down.
Yep, exactly. And Shaker can't really do this. Can't really do much. Sorry. When the Ember just Side of Fist into chains on Droll and the Skyward ulti is dropped there with silence on her, Fissure won't help her at all.
Yeah, and then you've got the swap as well. Like, swap is decent up against the Fissure if it gets placed in between, you know, the Drow Ranger and the SF or something like that. Yeah. Brewmaster,
so
fifth pick.
Yeah, they're going for almost full in your face heroes, the last two picks. Because they need initiation against Droll Ranger, and it's a Phoenix.
And Phoenix does do pretty well with the Drow Ranger. The increase on his base damage allows him to do so much more in the offlane.
Yeah. I've never seen Alliance playing Phoenix.
Oh, me neither.
Lately, so I never, like, just didn't see them playing this hero. I'm curious how they're gonna synergize with it, or at least play around it, or with it, we'll see.
But they've got Troll and Drow, pretty much global heroes with their abilities. Visage with the familiars, they can take down towers pretty easily, but getting to those towers will be the difficult thing, I feel. With Brewmaster, Ember, and Shadowfiend, pretty good at controlling heroes in front of towers. Scarath Mage and Vengeful Spirit, pretty much same thing.
Yeah, I mean, Alliance, they have a really good lineup for Roche as well. They can just kill the Roche on really fast with Medallion on Visage and draw plus Troll Warlord. They can sneak a Roche, even draw plus Visage, they can sneak a Roche with a Smoke. So, in my insanity, it looks like they have a DC player. Okay, never mind.
Yeah
they have a DC. We have time to discuss more now. Right. Yeah, they have a really good lineup. And Shaker can also protect them when they're rushing. While they're rushing, he can protect them. He can just block heroes here with the Fissure and prevent them from going to rush with. Oh,
and Phoenix,
I like
Phoenix is
potential.
Phoenix is one of the best heroes at defending Rushdown as well. There are so many spots you can just get your supernova off on top of cliffs or something like that, and that makes it so the opponent can't get in there. Like, there is no route into Rush Pit when that supernova is down.
This is really interesting. Yeah, you're right, I agree. The Phoenix on the Rush Pit, taking a fighter, it's quite scary against the Phoenix. We'll see how he's going to do on laning stage, because
he's
Scarlet
against Scarath Mage with Ancient Seal,
Scarath Mage is known, I think it's the best zoner as a single support. There's no way there's another support that can zone you harder and easier than this hero, because the nuke does insane amount of damage. I hate when I play offlane against this hero, it's really annoying.
Well,
it's going to be a safe lane ember.
That was like Scarath's rise to fame, when people were playing Tidehunter and Centaur constantly offlane. And there was no real way to deal with them. Like, you'd send Lion or Rubick or something, Telekinesis, Earthspike, like, okay, we stunned him, yay! But no real damage. And then Scarath started to get played more and more, and you just orb, right-click, right-click, orb, right-click, right-click, and it's just impossible to deal with. There's no amount of regen that you can have to deal with that kind of harass.
I mean, I guess Phoenix, when he sees Scarath is alone in his train, he can try to harass him back with the spirits, but I don't think you go spirits at level 1. Go dive, right? So if you're in danger, you can just Icarus dive away. Oh, because he might be able to trade some hits with the draw aura. So we'll see how
almost
this matchup offlane or
almost
goes.
Like an IHCS game. Loda, bringing back the old times. How long have you played Dota for? I'm guessing a long time.
I didn't play this. I was not in these times, old times. I played for like 4 years competitive.
Okay. So
5 years almost. I played Dota, all in all, for like 6 years, but I didn't play this competitive leagues in Dota 1 because I was not playing that much Dota.
Okay.
So bottom, they had a skirmish there with the Phoenix. They managed to take him to half HP because he has really low armor. Scarlet Mage, you can see this hero. So I'm watching, and I don't think Ember Spirit did any right clicks. He just took that damage with some right clicks from Scarlet Mage and some, like, one nuke.
Yeah.
I didn't really watch bot.
I don't think Ember was really needed at all. No, I think Mitch just stood there right clicking the Phoenix trying to control that rune.
Yeah.
Who actually got the rune up on top lane? So it was Ember on the bot and Pycat up on top. So Pycat gets a nice little early start there, but the lane is pushing pretty much all the way back into his tower. So this lane, how far does... Oh, he's controlled this quite well now. So it's going to be on the top of his ramp. That's unfortunate for the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, it's quite unfortunate, but the thing is he didn't really block because he went for the bounce rune. And his lane was in SF tower, and the tower pushed automatically the wave. Oh, by far now, SF is doing a nicely job. I think Troll Warrior wins in the early stages, like I said. And he can kill him, though. He's going for a kill here.
Can he get this, though? Two more hits. Three more hits now with the salve. Not quite enough. And he gets no bottle delivered. He gets a salve delivered to him.
He needs a salve delivered because he can't really stay. If he goes with his HP, he will die when Troll has his slow.
Pycat looking for more.
You see Shaq? He stayed bottom. He threw a fissure. And Niqua managed to get level 2.
EGM wanted to try and get a fissure onto that Shadowfiend mid, but salving up. There won't be an opening again. Now, Brewmaster up on top lane, getting quite a lot of damage applied to him by Loda and Ake there. What's the role of this Vengeful Spirit in this dual lane?
I think he needs to stay here in case... Because if he's not here, Alliance, they'll go... Draw and Visage, they'll go ham on this Brewmaster. But looks like they're actually going now.
Yeah,
but Draw, with
Venge anyway.
Being here, he can... He can... go and stun a draw ranger, they can get a clap off and the draw will die.
Oh, mid lane, is pretty tanky. Milan getting stunned up by the Fissure, but now EGM is in the wrong neighborhood. Two raises, one more hit from the Skyrath, and that's first blood.
That was nice. Did he Skyrath Mage TP or he just rotated?
I think he just walked. Well, they were pinging out the Earthshaker when he was standing here earlier. They knew he was there. So I think Skyrath Mage just walked over there, trying to find where he was. Because he wasn't showing bot lane. He wasn't holding the lane back with Fissure or anything like that. And now damage onto the troll as well. But Milan, do you have a bottle or anything incoming?
Oh, that was a nice play from Pycat. He cancelled another self.
Oh dear.
Skyrath Mage gave to SF. So SF is in a pressure now. He has
to buy another salve.
Yeah, and Phoenix, this is getting some space from Phoenix bottom. He's managed to get level 3 now. And you don't want to play a melee hero against the Phoenix on the lane. He's quite annoying when he's getting his spirits off on you.
What do we expect?
Like, Cole is playing aggressive.
What do we expect from Loda here? Go for Wraith Bans and try and spam them out? Because if this lane continues, a bot lane is being Phoenix. Oh, mid lane, Fissure onto two. Pycat trying to go in here onto Milan, gets plenty of damage down with the Whirling Axes. Not sure if he can follow. EGM trying to get the courier, but will find Mitch, surely. The magic missile lands, the Wave of Terror, they turn it around and get a kill on EGM. I thought Pycat would go back in there with Whirling Axes coming off cooldown, but with that Vengeful Spirit making an appearance.
I think Pycat had a chicken as well, but he didn't see it. He was in the crypts there, could have gone range form.
It's a tiny little rabbit.
Top lane.
Goggy.
Might have a kill on Brewmaster.
Yeah,
the nuke,
they've got Soul Assumption.
Yeah,
max
dead.
Charges on Soul Assumption, pretty much. Nuke to the face. But
Alliance really took advantage of the Venge TP made and just trading their kills for kill.
Okay.
Oh, Pycat.
Loda has answered my question for me. He's going Wraith Bands.
Yeah, he always goes this build, the mass Wraith Bands, because of the agility.
So do you go two Wraith Bands or three?
I think he goes three.
And then treads?
Once he went four, I think. I don't know.
Really?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I think so. But he usually goes three Wraith Bands.
Was that two misses by the Brewmaster there, evading the Frost Arrows from Loda? Yeah. Pretty lucky on the Drunken Brawler.
So, this SF is getting quite crushed mid. He had a... Like, it was a weird-ass situation on mid lane. First, he get his salve canceled. No, his first salve went off. Then he got a salve from his chicken, got canceled.
And then
Skyrath Mage gave him a salve and got canceled.
And he still doesn't have bottle, like, almost 5 minutes into the game.
He bought another salve now, though, and I don't know. He's not doing... He has 9 CS to 22 Throne Warner. But it's a shadow of him. He will always recover in CS-wise.
One of the best flash farmers in the game, pretty much.
Yeah.
Especially if you've got stacked camps, which he has one stack on the large camp down there, but no others, it looks like.
And meanwhile, this time, Phoenix might be dying bottom. He has a Icarus dive.
Looks like he's okay for now.
But
he's
level, though.
Oh dear. Loda trying to turn things around with the Battle Trance applied. He's got that attack speed, but he can't find the hits. Spreading the damage across the Venge and the Skyrath. And now Brewmaster's coming in, but Loda will just back up.
I mean, nice rotation from the supports. You were diving pretty far there, pretty deep. But yeah, this Phoenix will get a level 6 quite soonish. And to play a big, pretty big role in the next dive MO Insanity will make on top, maybe, if you want to go for a kill. The Phoenix can't be there. You already bought a TP, now bought a TP on him.
Loda has fewer last hits than the Phoenix does. Well, he's just evened up, but 15 last hits on the Drow Ranger compared to the 30 of the Ember and the 30 of the Troll Warlord. How has this happened? Was it just because the Brewmaster and Venge are so good at controlling the lane and getting denies out?
Yeah, I mean, Brew has 11 denies, so I guess that's the reason. Because without that, Loda would have like
28?
20 CS plus. So, bottom.
Oh, no!
He's a dead
Phoenix. It's going to follow him. It's going to kill him.
Phoenix, Dota.
But now the Troll Ward comes in. Mitch pays for it with his life, and he's going to look for more, but Pycat can't catch the Ember Spirit. Places down a Remnant, so he'll be able to jump straight back into that lane, fill up his bottle. But does he jump into the lane? Because EGM is waiting for the Fissure, and they see this. They've got vision on him.
Pardon me, I wanted to say Scarlet Mage. All mid lane, they're going with haste control. Shadow Fiend is dead.
Haste still, just about wearing out, but look at that damage. Pike out with the right clicks, Ake with the nuke. And Loda, pretty defensive up on this top lane.
Pike doesn't care at all, he's just going on the tower, scouting people. This is how strong Troll Warder is. You can do these things without really care about almost. He knows this is his territory now. He doesn't really care about what can happen. This is a hero. This is how strong this Troll Warder. It's very annoying to play against.
Man, it was even more annoying in Dota 1 when his first skill, it was the transformation, so you could dodge stuns with it. That was stupid.
Oh, they're going top again. They want to force a split.
Well, he's not going to use the clap just yet. Turns around onto Ake. There's the concussive shot, slowing him down. No crits yet from the Brewmaster, but the orbs will hit. Ake going to get taken down.
I think he could have tried to nuke the Brewmaster there. They've tried to force a split at least. Oh yeah, that was a nice rotation again from Scarlet Mage. He's doing very good rotations. He's pretty fat though. He has two nulls on him.
And magic stick, boots, 500 gold.
Boots. He's quite a snowball Scarlet Mage now. Despite he died bottom, doesn't matter. He's getting kills.
And those nulls. Those nulls rack up the damage. Like, it's quite surprising.
Yeah. And I like that he's not maxing the first spell. The Ancient Seal level, he has two in first and two in Ancient Seal. That's a good build against these heroes, like against Phoenix or his heroes with escape mechanism.
Especially when you've got other heroes like Ember and SF who do magic nukes as well, Searing Chains and Razors. Yeah. You can amplify their damage on top of yours. Definitely a good choice.
And Brewmaster opted to go for this Orb of Venom again against the range heroes. Well, I don't know, but seems it's working for him. They're going for a smoke though. They have a smoke mid. He has portraits. They want to wrap around mid lane and try to go on the troll. They want to bait the SF maybe. I'm not sure what they're trying to do here.
Brew is tanky as all hell. I mean, 1100 HP, 4 armor, plus split and the Drunken Brawler. He is really difficult to take down.
Yeah, Pycat is dead mid.
Concussive shot, Ancient Seal, the nukes are real. Gogi gonna get one more hit, but the raise finishes him off. Milan taking him down. Revenge! For the amount of times that Pycat was diving under his towers, cancelling his salves. And now, a juicy old stack for the Shadow Fiend. What a surprise.
Yeah, he got a kill, and suddenly he has power threats and almost same CS as a Troll Warrior. Like, this is how this hero works.
Like, he got his bottle 5 minutes in. He had, like, Wraithband bottle 5 minutes. And then at 10 minutes, he's got Treads bottle, Wraithband, and 600 gold. That's pretty good for him.
Visage got his level 6 bottom, by the way. He got his birds going on. And they gave lane top Phoenix. I don't know. Oh, I think it was when he rotated, when he tried to go on Panda and they gave up Ake life.
Yeah.
So he stayed there, Pycat, checking him rune. Or he wants to just go zone out the Shadow Fiend. It's pretty manly though.
Yeah, there's still tier 1 tower standing up there. SF gonna try and TP out. One hit bash. Nope. Not gonna get it. The familiars were looking to stun as well, but nice TP from the SF. Pressure will be applied onto this tier 1 tower, though. Three Wraithbands up on Loda.
Might be dead. Yeah, he's pretty dead.
Poor old Vengeful Spirit. He applies that debuff, though, over onto the Phoenix and the Earthshaker.
At least he leaves something behind.
Yeah.
Oh, they're defending mid tower, though. Brewmaster should be careful.
He gets silenced up and then stunned by the familiars, but in comes the Ember Spray. Goes straight onto Pycat. Searing Chain's going to hold him in place, but the damage output from Loda there, with the Battle Trance, just ripping that poor old Ember to shreds and turns it around onto the Shadow Fiend. That SF had no route in, and then he had no escape. While the Phoenix jumping forward, trying to get some more Fiery Spirits onto Mitch there.
They really underestimate the power of Draw Ranger Aura. Like, even Brewmaster, I mean, I agree, he's tanky and all, but you can't really underestimate the damage output from this Draw Ranger and, like, these range heroes, even the birds or the Phoenix. He just melted to Phoenix with Brewmaster there. And I don't know if I agree with this portrait pickup on Brewmaster. You want to rush the Blink Dagger. You don't want to, because you never know. Things might not go so well for you. You go with this portrait and then you'll die. He died two times now, and he's pretty far away from his Blink Dagger, right?
Yeah.
But if he rushes it like Boots...
Bottle?
And... Not even bottle. You don't need bottle. You just go Boots, Blink, or he can do so much in fights. But not being able to initiate with a Blink Clap and Split is really rough against this lineup. Because you want to be in Draw Ranger's face and Focuser, or just Split and Yule the, I don't know, the Troll maybe, or something like that.
Maybe.
So yeah, Alliance, that was a nice fight.
Maybe even
he's
the Visage.
He's dealing a lot of damage.
Like, if you Cyclone the Visage, then there's no Soul Assumption. He's pretty hard to kill to begin with, so he's not really the main target you'd want to go onto. So if you Cyclone the Visage and then try and Boulder Toss onto the Drow, take her down.
Yeah. And you see how a Seraphine melted to Draw Ranger right clicks and Soul Assumption, Medallion, or he just died instant.
Yeah,
Ocean going down.
I'm not sure what he was doing though. Like, the Ember Spirit went in, he had a target, he had a plan. He was like, okay, I'm gonna kill this troll. And then Shadowfiend just walks in and things didn't go his way.
Yep.
The Radiant have smoked up here. Skywrath, Venge, and Shadowfiend trying to look for something, but Alliance playing quite defensively here. Pike out with the Invis Rune will scout everything out. My Insanity, not going to be able to find anything.
Yeah, they'll run into Pike out and it'll be like, someone is here.
Oh, Familiars take two hits there. Pike out with a slow. Throws out some axes, but there comes the wave concussive shot. Silence onto the Brewmaster. He's going to get ripped to shreds. Pikett getting very low, but he'll respawn in a second. Searing Chains catches the Phoenix and the Earthshaker in the back end of play. Phoenix does go down, but the Earthshaker keeps on going. And now the Ventral Spirit getting chased down. There's a slow there from Pikett getting thrown out, just about landing. Onto the Ventral Spirit, now stunned from the Familiars. Whirling axes, two hits. And all they lose
is
the Phoenix.
This is pretty rough. The Panda, the Brewmaster, is not able to get a split off. He just walks there, claps, and then he gets gusted by the Draw Ranger, and he just dies to nukes and whatever is thrown at him. Like, I don't really know about the Brewmaster. If he's not getting his split off, it's really rough. They don't have teamfight control. And the Ember, he can't really just go in there and try to focus someone. He can get bursted as well.
They
do a lot of damage.
Have we seen Brew use his ultimate once this game?
I don't think he did.
No, I don't think he split at all. 13 minutes in.
Nope.
But then again, he has died three times in a row pretty much in every single team fight. The gusts from Loda have been on point. Like, whenever he sees the Brew walking in, he lets him clap, he lets him drop down by like 200 HP, and then he gusts when he knows the Brew is going to definitely primal split.
Yeah.
So he's got that timing down. It's just, like you said, the Brewmaster doesn't have Blink Dagger to actually initiate. Nowhere near BKB, obviously. So he's got no way of debuffing that.
Yep, there's nothing. He might be dead bottom now.
He's still got split. He has to use split there defensively. But
he was dead if he didn't.
But then, would you rather die than use your split like that?
I think he's dead. Oh, he has a Storm aspect. He should go Invis. I don't know why he's not. Okay.
Well, they turn around and EGM with a Mystic Flare. Now Gogi, probably dead here. Look at the damage from Loda. It's the DD on Troll. Didn't quite notice that in the middle of things, but turn on the Battle Trance and pump out the damage. But yeah, as a Brewmaster there, seeing as he died anyway, wouldn't you rather just die and then have your split for the next team fight? Because that's 100 seconds where you don't have that ultimate now. Maybe you look for a smoke into the Dire Jungle?
He still split and he still died.
Well, that's because he split and he went into the enemy. Like,
yeah,
he could have split and run away.
Top tower, I think you just accept that you're dead and you don't use... I mean, I don't know, like, he shouldn't be farming there when he doesn't see anyone on the map. Like, no one was showing on any lane and he went bottom to farm. And the Alliance, they're just team rolling them on the map now. There's no response from MY Insanity. And the Ember pick didn't really have any impact yet. Usually when you see Ember, he's played mid and he's, you know, securing runes, rotating. But in this game, it's really hard to do anything because they just got steamrolled all over the places. Venge is not 6 yet.
I feel Ember is one of those strange heroes where you have to play a mid for like the first 7 or 8 minutes because that's where he excels. He's got great burst damage, he's got Searing Chains to lock people down in 1v1s, and he can rune control. So the first 8 minutes, I feel like he's a mid hero. Who's that? Ventral Spirit. Not your day. Gonna try. Did he TP there? And then cancelled. Oh dear.
Yeah, I mean, this game is quite risky. Teams are scared of placing the Ember mid against some heroes troll. Like Troll, because he's gonna get crushed in the lane.
But if you have a Skyrath Mage, go and babysit the Ember Spirit, it should be fine.
Yeah, or Milan, Shadowfin, he's dying solo to Visage. He's...
Yeah. There are no words. He's just dead.
Even the Shadowfin picked off. I like it when it's right. Like, they first picked Shadowfin into Vengeful Spirit.
And now the Ember Spirit of bot lane gonna try and TP out. Does Loda have enough damage? Yes, he does! With a tower helping out.
Top lane as well.
Are they just losing heroes in every single lane?
Yeah,
Shadowfiend dies in the Roche pit. Brewmaster dies on... Wait, where did Brew die? Mid?
He died top lane to Troll. We got some lucky bashes. Got a kill on the Brewmaster.
Oh yeah. Ember Spirit died bot. Shadowfiend in the Roche pit. Brewmaster died top.
This is getting out of control.
And look at where Nico's standing right now. They've got vision of this camp. He's going to jump over Atos onto the Vengeful Spirit. Now she can TP out. And there's no stun from the Phoenix.
Yes, Atos. Okay.
Yeah, run of Atos Phoenix. Why not?
Yeah, I don't know what to say. Radiance, this is getting out of control for my Insanity. They don't have a response. Okay, I also feel the draft is... I mean, it looked fine in the beginning, but then... I keep forgetting about this Troll Warner and his ultimate as well.
And Drow.
Doing so much.
Like it's Troll and Drow. Like the...
Drow, Troll, yeah.
As long as Drow stays back and keeps that aura going on the ranged heroes, then Troll turns on Battle Trance. Towers get destroyed really damn quickly, but when they find one hero, they just evaporate. There's no way to escape because they don't have four staffs. They've got no like Shadow Blades or Blinks or anything to just jump out of these team fights. They just have to take that damage and hope they respawn quickly.
And it also, this draw pick really, I think, really played a mind game into my Insanity, because I'm pretty sure they had a plan when they picked Draw Ranger, because they picked Shadowfiend Venge, and Alliance knew they played this Shadowfiend Venge draw in the past days. So Pikerman said, okay, I'm gonna pick Draw Ranger so they won't get it. And after they picked it, I feel like my Insanity, they kind of dropped their guns off. They had nothing to react. They just picked this Ember Spirit, and Panda seems like they have no plans with it. They have no plan with it, so I don't know. Maybe that draw pick played a really big mind game during the draft.
It definitely took them a long time to think about that Ember pick.
Yeah.
When Alliance picked up the Drow. And the Ember hasn't had a great farming game. Like, he's still struggling to buy Battle Fury. This is the kind of situation you see solo mid Embers. They excel early on in the game, they get quite a lot of farm, they get like phase drums. But he's gone phase bottle, and he's still trying to make Battle
Fury.
He's
really squishy though. He just dies. If he gets one bash from Troll, he's dead. If they focus him. Yeah. I don't know. I don't like to see too many squishy heroes in a lineup, but I don't know.
And like, Loda now has gone from pretty much one of the lowest CS on cores on a safe lane I've seen in a long time to having the highest net worth. But their lineup is pretty much the epitome of mid-game lineup. Yeah. Like, they've got the Drow with the Visage to take down towers, take down Roshan, find pickoffs. They've got the Earthshaker and Troll, who offer a lot of mid-game power as well. EGM, how close are you to Blink Dagger? 1,200 gold away.
Is that close? Oh, he's one... He's... Well, he's gonna get it there slowly but surely. Well, I just wanted to say that Lion's Draft allowed them to pressure the enemy safely as well.
Okay,
and
has
you want
ags.
To do this almost every game. You want to have drafts that can allow you to pressure the enemy safe lane, because that's the lane when they feel safe and they farm, right? That's why it's called safe lane. So you go there, you pressure, you just take tower, and then from there on, you just focus on objectives like Roshan, warding the map, warding the enemy jungle, all the stuff.
Yeah, because the majority of safe lane heroes, once that tier 1 tower goes down, they want to stick on the top lane, or stick on the safe lane and farm for another couple of minutes.
Yeah, and I gotta say, this, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I feel the only reason they're doing that, and they did that in the beginning, was this Troll Warlord. He's he doesn't care where he goes. He just goes into a jungle, he meets three heroes, and even if he dies so hard that it opens up space for the other lanes.
Yeah, you have to expend like three ultis and a lot of time.
Yeah, and it's also, this hero fits PJ really well, because he's kind of player who wants to be there in their enemy faces, and he's not doesn't care about anything. He just goes there and he's gonna be, yo, I'm here, what you gonna do about it, you know? So this is, that's why Pycat, it's, I feel like it's he's doing really strong job. He's really strong on his heroes because it fits his style.
Yeah, definitely.
So I also think they should have banned the troll word. I don't know, when I play, if I play Alliance, I will always ban troll if I don't want to pick it, because like, they seem to play really well with it and around it.
Well, what did MindSanity banned out the Wisp and the Juggernaut, didn't they?
Yeah, they banned Jagger. I don't know. I feel like troll is much stronger than the Juggernaut. I mean, the Juggernaut offers you strong late game hero, even mid game or fast Roche, but the same does with troll, right? The same thing happens with troll.
Except and the troll wins you a lane.
Yep, Juggernaut doesn't really win. If it's safe lane, it's definitely going to be safe lane. But the thing about Jagger, he has kill potential on the offlaner, right? You get level 6, the offlaner needs to be careful. One Omni Slash and he's dead. Or these kind of things. But the Juggernaut doesn't really offer the team, you know, this pressure potential in the beginning, like Troll does. Like I said, he just goes on mid, for example. He trades hits with SF, he kills SF, almost kills him. They have to rotate heroes there. He's going into your jungle. He's giving a lot of info about where the supports are.
It's kind of like an offlane hero, but played mid.
He's like a Bristol bag with farm.
Offlane heroes nowadays, they're trying to draw the supports in so that mid and safe lane are safer. But the troll does that for mid lane. Mitch, look at the damage. Slow down Fire Spirits and Rod of Atos. The Ember trying to get as much splash out as possible with his freshly made Battle Fury. Now, Brewmaster, where do you want to go? Because you just got Fissured. The rest of your team is locked behind that rock wall. EGM with the plays. No one can make their way out of this Radiant base to help. Troll Waller takes down Gogi. The Brewmaster, no buyback, no ultimate. And Pycat looking for more. Damage onto Milan. The Shadow Fiend taking so much. I've got to stun up that damn Troll Warlord.
Man, this is over, dude. This game is completely... The Shadow Fiend went 4-step.
Yep. I noticed
the Brewmaster, he blinked without clapping, he was scared of getting silenced, he blinked split, so... this is getting way too... This is way too one-sided.
9-19, 22 minutes into the game. But let's ask the question that we did before, you know, when MindSanity had that tiny Wisp and they were running down lanes and there was nothing to stop them, hypothetically, mYi, if they can defend high ground for another 15 minutes, get Ember Spirit, another Battle Fury or something like that. Shadow Fiend some damage items. They could potentially turn this around.
I think they can stall a bit. I mean, they can stall with... Now he got a Battle Fury. But once... If they're Alliance, they commit with the control. I don't know. Like, you can't really do anything. And then Shaker has a Blink now. He can just jump on the Ember Echo Slamming. And he's dead. Donzo. Like, I don't know...
EGM, are you gonna go for this?
Yeah. He might try though. Dire's structures are fortified. But yeah, I don't see how they win. To be honest, I don't wanna make them. They're not listening to me, but I'm just saying. Lola has a Manta now with a Blink dagger. We didn't really mention that he has a Blink.
He's got Eagle Song on the courier as well.
I didn't see that.
He just bought. He's had that Manta for a couple of minutes.
So
he
went
up.
Full agility mode now.
Oh yeah. How much bonus damage is he giving that Troll Warlord? 70 bonus damage.
Yeah, that's a lot of damage. So yeah, they're making use of the Aegis now. Ember is there with the fist. But the Shadow Fiend, it's not doing anything in this type of situation. He just raises once and that's it. He's not really... Oh, there was a nice Fissure there.
But once Alliance goes high ground with the familiars, what's to stop that tier 3 from 4?
Yeah, if they get a good initiation on Phoenix, try to burst him fast, they might stand a chance. But there's also a Shaker and an Aegis Troll. Troll is about to lose his Aegis here.
That's fine now. Shadow Fisher, Fiend. Atos. Yeah, look at how much damage he's taken. EG actually blinks forward there, stunned up, he's dead. Not sure what his plan was. I think he wanted to go for the sneaky enchant totem and kill, but primal split used after the blink clap. Brewmaster trying to get something here. Cyclone, who'd he throw it out on? Onto the Visage. Remnant forward from the Ember Spirit. What's Pycat doing in the back? Oh, Loader, look at that damage. Turn around and hit that Ember Spirit. Familiar stuns. Arke saving his teammate. Keeping him alive that little bit longer to pump out the damage, and now Brewmaster taking the nukes, taking the damage from this Visage. While Supernova goes off and Mystic Flare. But there's not too much that My Insanity can do. They're getting shredded here.
I mean, they had a decent initiation there with the blink, clap, split. But Loda had Manta, so he dispelled the clap slow with the Manta stack, ran away. But other than that, really do anything. His troll warlord is just going ham mode. Buyback on Shadow Fiend, they looking to defend this last mid tower or throne tower.
But how can they do it? Like, Pycat's just gonna turn around and Brewmaster's probably gonna die here. Drow and Troll both going up high ground. Vengeful dies. Saves his teammate for a short while. The Frost Arrow, the first hit misses, allowing him to blink backwards. Now Milan with the Ghost Scepter, trying to dodge as much of this physical damage as possible, but no. Ember Spirit is just trying and trying, but the damage output from the Troll and the Drow Ranger. And then Nico on his Phoenix. GG. So there we have it. My Insanity winning game one, but Alliance taking game two off their hands. So it's drawn at one apiece here in the MLG Pro League.
Yeah, strong performance from Alliance in game two. I mean, they were doing, they did fine in game one as well, but the draft didn't allow them to face up against the Tiny Wisp and the Razor. So well played by both teams.
But that's it for tonight. We'll be back tomorrow at 2 p.m. CET, I think. Well, I will be anyway, with some Southeast Asian Dota from the MLG Pro League. I've been Durka. You can follow me on Twitter at DurkaDota. Joining me, Ar1se. What's your Twitter handle? Is it at Ar1se?
Twitter is at Ar1se with one and underscore 2012. But you'll find me easily. I also stream pretty often with twitch.tv/Ar1se with I, not one, underline 2012. I'm getting a new PC tomorrow and I will start streaming in HD because,
Oh boy. HD plays. The Magnus plays in HD. Well, thanks for joining me. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thanks for having me. See ya.